In this video lecture, we'll take a look at our next Java building block, identifiers. These are the names we get to specify for things when writing a Java program. Okay, let's get started. Identifiers in Java are user-created symbolic names. These are the names that we get to give to things we create in Java programs, such as variables, methods, and classes, the three main container types we discussed in the last video lecture. Identifiers have some certain restrictions on their names. There are certain naming requirements that must be followed per the Java language. And then there are certain well-established naming conventions that should be followed. We'll talk about these well-established conventions for good names as we introduce those various other language elements. First of all, here is a list of requirements that our identifiers must follow per the Java language specification. Identifiers must be composed only of certain allowable characters, which for our purposes consist of the letters A through Z in both upper and lower case, numbers, underscores, and perhaps the dollar symbol. We can also use many other Unicode characters, but we won't really get into that too much. Identifiers cannot contain any spaces, and they cannot begin with a numerical digit, although digits after the first character are perfectly acceptable. Identifiers cannot be the same as any of Java's reserved words, which we'll cover in the following video lecture. Identifiers are case sensitive, which for example means that the uppercase and lowercase versions of the same letter are considered to be distinct from one another. And finally, the length of an identifier is essentially unlimited, although I think good common sense tells us that we should stick to reasonable lengths for our identifiers. So again, these are the musts for any classes, variables, or methods that we create in Java. Here are some examples of Java identifiers we might want to use to name our classes, variables, or methods. The ones on the left are acceptable in Java's eyes, but the ones on the right are all invalid. In each case, can you see why? In the first case, the identifier 4 is invalid because it begins with a digit. The same thing is true of the second example. In this example, the number symbol at the end of student ID makes this an invalid identifier. The blank space within student 1 makes this one invalid. 2013 taxes is an invalid name because again it begins with a digit. But its counterpart on the left is just fine. These next two on the right, void and class, are invalid because they are Java reserved words, which we'll get to next. Finally, @systeminfo is invalid because it contains a non-Java letter, the @. All of these identifiers on the left are fine, although we might probably do better on some of these namings. We'll talk about good naming conventions as we go along. Here is your Hello World program from your first lab exercise in week 1. Notice that all of the identifiers have been underlined in red. Notice also that these represent several different types of Java elements. Here we see the name of the class, Hello World, as an identifier. Identifiers can also represent method names, such as main and print greeting. And finally, identifiers can represent variables, such as first name, last name, and args. So to summarize, identifiers in Java are the names we give to quantities that we get to define. They have certain naming requirements per the language, and then there are good practice conventions, which we'll get to as we go along. Okay, that's it on identifiers.